A pivot table is another way to profile the data in a tabular format. In this example, we will create a table showing the payment totals for the different combinations of people who authorized and posted payments. Make sure the payments database is active. On the Analysis tab, in the Categorize group, click Pivot Table. First, we need to give the pivot table a name. Enter Payments Pivot Table and click OK. An empty pivot table appears with the Field List dialog box. The process of creating a pivot table in IDEA is graphical, so we simply drag and drop fields to the row, column, or data areas. Start by clicking on Posted By and drag it to the area that says Drop Row Fields here. Next, click Off and drag it to the area that says Drop Column Fields here. If you accidentally drag the wrong field into the pivot table, you don't have to start over. Just highlight that field in the dialog box and click Remove. I'll drag Off back to the Column Fields area. Now, drag the Amount field into the middle area. Since we want to see payment totals, drag Amount to where it says Drop Data Items here. Now click Close on the dialog. The pivot table displays a subtotal of the payments for each combination of authorizer and poster. The sum of all payments posted by CW and authorized by BC is $109,130.41. By default, the values in the data grid are totals, but this can be changed by right-clicking in the grid to open the pivot table field dialog box. Let's change the display from sum to count and click OK. Now we see the number of payments rather than the total of payment amounts. Notice that in both the row and column headers, there is a blank field. These represent records that contain blank values for posted by or off. We can also see that some of the same values appear in both the posted by and off fields, like CW. There are two records that were posted by and authorized by CW. To view these records, double-click the two. A preview window appears with those two payments. Click Done to close the preview window. We selected just one field for the row, column, and data areas of the pivot table, but each of those areas can have more than one field displayed. On the Pivot Table toolbar, click the first button to reopen the Pivot Table Field List dialog. Drag the Supplier Number or SUPNO field to the Row area, placing it to the left of Posted By. Click Close on the dialog. The Pivot Table displays the same information, payment totals by poster, but it is broken down even further by the supplier. Because many of the cells don't contain data, it may be helpful to filter out some of the field values. Let's focus on payments posted by Jen and UUU. Click the drop-down arrow in the Posted By field header and select only the checkboxes for Jen and UUU. We can uncheck all of the other boxes individually, or we can uncheck the Show All box and then just check off the boxes only for Jen and UUU. Click away from the drop-down list to apply the changes. We can also collapse or expand the details of each supplier number using the plus and minus signs next to each one. In the Properties window, click Data to return to the database view. A pivot table is a type of result output, so like the summarization and stratification results that we created previously, we can review the pivot table by clicking Payments Pivot Table in the Results section of the Properties window.